You know, I don't know if it's just me, but this tastes more like October than even pumpkin spice ales.
Oh, for sure.
What's up, guys? I'm Jake.
John. I wanted to do it first this time. You always get to do it first. I'm John.
I'm Jake.
And this is Half Lit. Another day of October. Welcome back. Today we have a wonderful brew by one of my favorite breweries. Oddside. Oddtoberfest.
It seriously has to be one of our favorite breweries because at this point, this is our third one.
I love Oddside, dude. Everything they make is so tasty. Oddside, we love you. Give us sponsorship.
Yeah.
Send us free beer. Support us. We'll support you.
Yeah. Comment on this video. Tell us to come to your brewery and we'll show up.
Oh, yeah. We'll be there in a heartbeat.
And we'll make a video of it and... You know,
we'll blast
I know
it.
We're small, but...
We'll blast it as far as we can.
We expect something like a comped meal, a beer, even just a beer, or a t-shirt.
Oh, I would love a t-shirt.
Yeah. Send us one thing each.
Anyways,
back to your beer. So, Oddside. Oktoberfest edition. Like John said, this is another addition to the month of October where we try nothing but seasonal beers. And this is Oktoberfest, and this is our first Oktoberfest.
Yeah,
we can't just dismiss Oktoberfest.
Listed as a deep gold / copper color, full-bodied lager with a rich malty flavor and notes of caramel. 5.6% ABV.
This sounds really good.
It's gonna be a pretty much basic beer, like all Oktoberfest.
Yeah, because you've probably had like, I think Sam Adams comes out with the Oktoberfest.
Sam Adams, I've had, what's that domestic brand that always does Oktoberfest? Maybe I just
think that is Sam Adams, because I clarify them as domestic.
Yeah, I mean, they're
pretty, but it might only be Eastside.
But no, they're domestic. They're everywhere. But
how do you know? Have you been to California?
No, but I've heard through the great. I listen to a lot of podcasts. Anyways, I've had another one other than Sam Adams, and they tasted the same to me. But that was a real long time ago because I see Oktoberfest stuff, and I'm usually like, if we get comments saying that you would prefer us to do more Oktoberfest, Michigan brews or craft brews, next October, we'll do a gauntlet.
Yeah.
You guys will get a good, probably 30 to 40 minute video of straight Oktoberfest gauntlet. We'll set up a whole board and everything. We'll get the brackets going.
Oh yeah.
1v1.
Ooh.
October Madness.
Ooh. That sounds hella fun. So you guys should definitely do that if you really want us to see that.
Yeah.
It'll be next year.
We'll try and get some more people for that too.
Yes. Get some guests on the show.
For the Oktoberfest gauntlet, I think we need it. I don't think that it's fair to have just us two. So we need at least three other people to make it odd.
Oddside.
Let's
get into it.
Yeah. Good segue, Jacob.
Good segue.
Oh, fuck. We fucked up.
What the fuck? I fucked up opening the can. How do you fuck up opening the can?
I don't know. You're two beers down and you didn't have breakfast.
Oh, man.
We didn't do ASMR. I'm kind
of
upset.
Oh, my God. I don't think we've ever missed one.
My blood alcohol level is never gonna stop going up.
Oh, that's a good picture.
That is like, that's not gold.
That is a lager if I've ever ever seen one. What makes an Oktoberfest beer an Oktoberfest beer? That is the question of the day.
They just say it.
Because do all of them put caramel? I don't think so.
What else do they put in it?
What makes this? What makes you the way you are? A deep gold copper color.
That's what I see. Yeah, it's definitely a deep gold copper. Yeah,
I can see it.
For sure. I like it. It's a beautiful color.
I like it.
It's nice. Oh, wait, what?
This is my third time smelling it.
I almost took another sip.
I forget every... Oh, my God.
Wait. Stop talking. I gotta focus on the scent.
Yeah.
I'm literally getting nothing.
I don't know about you. Well, I kind of get a caramel.
I hear that, but mainly it just smells like beer.
You hear it? Speaking to me, it's like, I'm there. Just a hint.
Yeah, it is just the tiniest hint.
It's literally notes.
Yeah, but it mostly just smells like a lager. So, with that, let's get to tasting it. I'm excited.
Oh, that's good.
Oh, that's really good. That is smooth and crisp at the same time.
You know, I don't know if it's just me, but this tastes more like October than even pumpkin spice ales.
Oh, for sure.
Fuck those. Like, when I tasted it,
I'm
like, it's October.
Oh, even this aftertaste, the tail of it, I'm getting the caramel.
Mm-hmm.
A lot. But not, like, overwhelmingly a lot. It's just, like, the hints, the, like, you know that, like, smoky bit of caramel that just kind of lingers? That's all I'm getting. And that's my favorite part of caramel.
Yeah.
Personally.
See, I like this a lot more than I like the barrel-aged, you know, one that we tried at Founders, barrel-aged. Because, like, it kind of almost tastes like this, but it's, like a lager version of that, you know, diluted a little bit.
It's not as bourbon.
A little bit easier to drink, you know. It kind of tastes similar to that. It's just, like, it's a better version.
It does. Yeah, I definitely hear you on that one.
But this is a really good one. And we're not just saying that because in the beginning we're talking about Oddside. Dude, Oddside has yet to disappoint.
Yeah.
It's the one brewery that I can say that has yet to disappoint.
I mean, like, you definitely get the Budweiser. If you think about just, like, a Budweiser.
Oh, yeah.
Straight up. Or Miller High Life, you know?
Mm-hmm.
But then it's, like, smoother than both of those.
It is so nice. Way smoother.
It's refreshing and warming at the same time.
More flavor.
Oh, yeah. This is the October beer so far. Anyways, this is delicious. On that first sip, I was almost tempted to just not stop because it tasted so good.
I've seen you nonstop drink a beer. It's scary sometimes.
It's rare. This is delicious.
And we've been just talking about it. We haven't said taste. A rating for taste.
Oh my God. And I'm almost
We're
done.
We're almost done.
It's so good. I'm hesitant, but I'm gonna give it a... Honestly, I would buy this all the time. I really wish it wasn't seasonal. I'm gonna give it a
9.8.
9.8? For a lager? Lager? 9.8.
That has to be the highest score so far. I'm gonna give it a 9.5.
9.5.
Dude, it is so good.
Drinkability? Drinkability? I'm gonna give it a solid 9. I could drink this all day, have to be cold. You know, I would cold outside. Like, I would need it to be fall.
You said 9?
Yeah.
9? I'm gonna give it a 9 too.
All right. We're back. As you can tell, we're feeling it. You know.
Oh, we're feeling good.
Yeah, we tend to do more than one episode in a day.
You can tell. Usually it's like, we're for at least two videos. We at least do two at a time, usually.
And that first one usually gets us real good. For the next one, we're a lot more lively, as you put it. But we're back here to chug this Oktoberfest, which I'm kind of upset about because it tastes so good. I don't want it to go that quick.
I know. I might. You kind of just want to fucking enjoy it.
Yeah, I'm just glad it's a six pack, so we have like another two, one for each of us, if we want to just taste it one last time.
Right.
All right. So with that, let's get to it.
Let's do a chug.
Do the chug. One last sniff. All right. That was pretty sharp. I'm gonna give it like a 6 on chugability. That hurt. I mean, shotgun wise, probably way easier. Check out our TikTok. We'll do a video of all the ones we shotgunned, but just chugging from a glass. Because shotgunning is completely different. But I'm gonna 6 is me being nice. I'm gonna give it like a 4. It's super sharp.
Oh.
It's too sharp to chug. It feels like it's stabbing you in the throat. Oh, what a waste.
What'd you give it?
I gave it a 5.
A 5 for chugability? Okay,
I'm just like, it's sharp. But it's not the worst thing we've chugged.
I didn't really want to exactly agree with you, but like...
Exactly a 5?
It's honestly, I would chug it again. So I'm gonna give it a 5.
Well, the bottle stop honestly, was pretty not, easy. It's not, it was so smooth. There was no sharpness whatsoever.
But this is pretty smooth too. It's not the harshest thing. It's not like the, IPAs.
But it does give you that sharp sting in your throat. And it's like with all lagers.
Yeah, so drinkability is pretty fair.
5. Yeah, 5. It's fair. I think 5 is good. You could chug this if you needed to or if you wanted to. You could chug this for sure. Personally, too sharp in my throat.
Mm-hmm.
I wouldn't chug this because what a waste of flavor. So next time... You guys will see us with an all new beer.
All new.
Extending our spooky season.
That will be the 5th week, the last week of October.
I think we might do something big for you guys
too.
I think so. A little extra added on.
Mm-hmm.
Because we love this spooky season.
And with that, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you want to see more of us, subscribe.
Yeah. Yeah, didn't mean to cut him off, but subscribe.
Yes. And then, if you want to see more of us...
Outside the realm of the videos, Instagram at halflit_reviews, and same for TikTok. We'll see you guys there, hopefully. And we'll see you guys here next time.
Next time.
All right, deuces.
Deuces!